What's going on, guys? It's your man Ed Hayes, the Wholesale Coach here, back for another video. And in this video, I want to share with you all 5 tips on how to get more wholesale real estate deals this year and beyond. Now, what's the number one thing that we all want to do out here in our business? We want to make more money. We want to run it up out here, right? So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about some strategic steps, methods, strategies that you can implement today to start increasing how many deals you're getting in your pipeline on a month-to-month basis. So I hope that you all are pumped for this content. Go ahead, hit that like button for me now, and let's get into it.
Push the button.
Push the goddamn button!
Push the goddamn button!
You heard what she said.
The first tip that I have for you all is gonna be to get attention. You've got to be able to make enough noise out here in the industry for people to actually pay attention to you. That means doing substantial marketing. That means using multiple different forms of marketing. So direct mail and cold call and text messaging and billboards and bench advertising and bus stop advertising. It's really about putting out as many nets of opportunity as possible. No one's going to know who you are if you're just barely scratching the surface of doing marketing. If you're only contacting 10 to 15 people per week, don't expect to actually become a household name. You gotta be relentless out here. You've gotta be willing to do whatever it takes. I don't know if some of you all noticed, but I've got a guest star in this one. This is my new baby girl, Ellie, out here. So salute to Ellie out here. She's out here rocking and rolling. She be chilling. I guess, so like I said, make sure that you get enough attention to actually let the market know that you exist. What I mean by getting attention is that if you're gonna be doing cold calling, try to reach out to at least 1,000 people per week. If you're gonna be doing direct mail, try to send out at least 500 mails at least 2 times per month. If you're gonna be doing text messages, try to send out at least 200 text messages per day or 1,000 per week. These are just the minimum quotas that you should give to yourself to actually get out here and try to make some things happen. If you're trying to do like a JV-centric type of business model, then you want to be giving at least 10 other wholesalers the opportunity to say yes every single day.
You smart.
Now, the next tip that I have for you all to get out here and start getting more wholesale real estate deals this year and beyond is gonna be to follow up quickly and consistently when new leads come in. Speed is the key, guys. You've gotta be moving quickly out here to actually get to the bag. You can't just be out here lollygagging, thinking about it, taking 2, 3, 4, 5 days to analyze a property and shoot over a contract. You've gotta be able to make quick, decisive actions and be able to follow up with people, let them know what's gonna happen, be the professional in these transactions, and actually get the job done. Now, at the beginning, I know it may be a little bit intimidating, or you may not know exactly what it is that you need to do, or if your numbers aren't correct and things of that nature. So I do recommend that you all get with a coach that resonates with you, that can help you through these processes so you can make quicker action. Don't wait until you've already got a lead in the pipeline, they're reaching out to you and you don't know what to do. In advance, make sure that you can be able to follow up quickly, know how to analyze these deals, make quick, decisive actions, so you can actually reach back out to the seller, follow up with them quickly, and also follow up with them consistently. Deals aren't closed on the first conversation, so make sure that you're in it to win it. For phone calls number 5 through 8 through 12, stay consistent, keep following up with these people. You're ultimately trying to help them, and the only way that you can help them is if you help them help themselves by following up with them consistently. Trust me, people will thank you that you were persistent in making sure that they actually got the job done. Remind them of their pain points. But speed is the key, guys. You gotta be moving quickly. So if you get a text message, you wanna be responding back to that text message, preferably within about 5 minutes or less, or 10 minutes, no more than about an hour. They feel like they're actively engaged in the conversation. If you send out a text message blast, but then you don't follow up with them for 8 hours, those leads are probably gone. So make sure that you follow up quickly, follow up consistently. Don't let these leads slip through the cracks. Now, the next tip that I have for you all is to master one method and then move to the next. Now, I know if y'all sitting here looking at YouTube, you know, there's a ton of different people saying a ton of different things, and people tend to end up in information overload or analysis paralysis. What I recommend to actually get more deals is to master one thing first. Don't be out there trying to do 20 million different marketing strategies at a time.
Isn't that cute? But it's wrong!
Start with one thing, master that, then move to the next strategy and start to stack more and more marketing strategies on top of where you already started. So in other words, don't try to become the jack of all trades. You want to become the king or queen of one trade first, then go to the next one, then go to the next one. That allows you to be able to focus your efforts up on one particular strategy. Master that, actually get good at helping this particular type of distress, for instance. You know, like, understand what it is that you're doing, understand the processes, then move on to the next process, then move on to the next list that you want to target. Try to not get all over the place. Even if you're going to learn about how to wholesale, don't learn from 15 to 20 different sources. Find you one to three different people that you learn the game from and just stick with it, and most importantly, take action. These deals aren't going to just come by themselves. You've got to be willing to put in that work, to actually get out here and sweat, hustle, bleed if necessary. Like, get out here, go on these appointments, go into these vacant distressed properties where the walls can be caving in and the floors are shaky and all of that stuff. Look, if you want to get out here and get to the bag, you've got to be willing to do what it takes. And that includes being focused enough to master one method and then move on to the next one in due time. Now, the next tip that I have for you all to get out here and start getting more wholesale real estate deals in and out of your pipeline is gonna be to game plan out your day for success. You can't just be out here winging it if you actually wanna get consistent deals. You need a clearly defined game plan for your day. So before you even wake up, like before you go to bed at night, what you wanna be doing is writing out your things to do list. And I actually made a video about this recently on the YouTube channel. I highly recommend that y'all check it out. I'm gonna link it up above. But you want to structure out your day like hour by hour. So from, you know, 8 to 9, I need to be, you know, checking in on Facebook, trying to get some JV opportunities. From 9 to 12:30, I need to be making some cold calls. From 12:30 to 1, maybe I need to get some lunch or something like that. From, you know, 1:30 to 2:30, maybe I need to be following up with buyers about these properties that we already have under contract. So that's, I just want you all to kind of think about it like that. You have to schedule out your day. You're not just gonna randomly get to where you're trying to go, or like your idea of success, without actually game planning for that. You have to know what your daily tasks are. And most of us are used to working a job. If you actually wanna break free from that job, then you need to become your own boss. If you don't want a boss no more, then you need to become your own boss. And that's why you need to schedule your day out for success. So when you know, look, I need to do X, Y, Z today, and then you lay it out on your calendar, like, okay, let me do X at this time, let me do Y at this time, and let me do Z at that time, and do you actually get this stuff done? Now you're on the path to success in your wholesaling business. So boom, that's tip number 4. And tip number 5 is gonna be outsource some of these tasks to others. Now, at some point in your business, you're gonna get to the point where you need to fire yourself from doing everything in the business. Or even if you're working a job, you just may simply not have enough hours to actually do what's necessary to realistically get consistent deals out here. So at some point, you're gonna wanna outsource some tasks to others. So I recommend hiring yourself a virtual assistant. I actually have an amazing plug on some virtual assistants that I'm gonna link it down below. Make sure that you check it out. But no matter where you get these VAs from, you need to at some point get some people that can actually help you run your business. Hire some people on to take care of some of the non-income producing activities, such as skip tracing and, you know, putting your leads into your marketing platforms like CallTools or Mojo or REI Reply or whatever it is that you're using. You want your business to be flowing as seamlessly as possible at some point. And that is gonna require you to at some point start to work on the business and not so much in the business. And I see this very, very often in people's businesses, like they're doing everything perfect, but they are the one reason why they aren't getting more deals. Because maybe they're, you know, holding on to that responsibility, or they're just not comfortable or familiar with hiring on new people, whatever it may be. Don't cheat yourself, treat yourself, help yourself out here. It takes a lot of work to consistently do wholesale real estate deals. Time is the real asset, y'all. Don't forget about that. A lot of us kind of sleep on time. We like, look, I want to give every single moment of my life to this business. But in all reality, a lot of you all who are doing that are actually shortchanging yourself, because you have that pride maybe that you want to hold on to everything in your business. At some point, you're going to want to delegate and outsource to others. Boom. So those are my five strategies and tips for you all on how to get out here and get more wholesale real estate deals. But look, low key, if you made it to this point, I want to give you one additional bonus strategy as well. I just want to tell y'all my philosophy. One of the most important tips that I can give you all is to go out there and get the buyers first. Like a lot of people teach you, go out there, find the sellers, and if it's a good deal, someone will buy it. But if you've never had any conversations with investors and you yourself don't have the money to purchase this property, please do not start contacting sellers telling them that you're gonna buy their property. That's just literally being a liar. And anyone who's telling you to go out there and be fraudulent and misrepresent yourself, you should probably unsubscribe to that. You should probably pay attention to how they're treating you as well. That's just like a nice little extra golden tip. I just wanted to drop that little golden nugget on you all who may just be getting started out here. If you really want to get quick, consistent deals, you got to have customers. Every business operates with customers, right? So, and the customer is the buyer. They're the ones who's coming to the table with the check. And so the more customers you have, the more sellers you can help. Like I said, a lot of people will tell you if it's a good deal, then someone will buy it. But what's a good deal is very subjective. John may only buy properties in the affluent suburbs, whereas Bob only buys property in like the hood, for instance. So what's a good deal to these two guys is gonna be totally different. So make sure that you're actually the one building up that relationship with the buyers, finding out what they actually want. Get to know your customer. And simply go out there and find inventory for your customers and provide them exactly what they're looking for. That's a quick, replicatable way to where you're actually running a business, and it's not a hobby, it's not a one-off. You actually have those relationships with cash buyers in those areas, so you know that you can get out here, get some more deals for these individuals, and keep doing business. It's not a hobby. This is actually how you build a business out here. All right, guys, so once again, those five tips on how to get out here and get more wholesale real estate deals are gonna be: one, get attention. Number two is gonna be follow up consistently and quickly. Number three is gonna be master one method, then move to the next. Number four is gonna be schedule out your day for success. You can't just wing it and actually get to the deals. And five is gonna be outsource some tasks to others. At some point, you're gonna need to delegate if you wanna scale up and do more deals. And the bonus tip was to make sure that you build your buyers list first. Now, I hope that you all are staying healthy, staying blessed out there. Make sure that y'all hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, drop me a comment down below. And until next time, guys, we are out. Say hello to good old Miss Ellie Simone. Ellie Simone Hayes. Say hello, Ellie. Oh, you okay? Oh, yeah. Oh, she about to start crying.